Tom right now is looking at free agency with his eye on that. They also are of the belief that he could go into Bill Belichick's office and Belichick could present him with a master plan. Tom Brady, though, I think is less inclined to believe that will happen than even those close to him are.
Here is where, before we sort of go free-for-all on this, here is where the story did move forward yesterday between you and Shefty. A lot of people are piecing together the fact that there have been no conversations thus far and using that as evidence, perhaps, that Brady is leaving. That, you're telling us, is not accurate.
No, so after what I said here, there were some reports that the CBA was what was holding up the negotiations between Tom Brady and the Patriots. To be very clear, what I was saying has nothing to do with that. This is Tom Brady's choice. It's not about whether the Patriots will get the chance to convince him. He could easily, without even meeting with the Patriots, go do what he wants to do. He is the one who is providing the Patriots with the chance to convince him to stay in New England.
First of all, Laura, you undersold the waves. The storm surge almost took out half of Brooklyn. And I'm surprised that it's still standing. However, when you look at this, there's one guy that we haven't really talked about a lot. We're talking about Tom Brady. We've talked about Bill Belichick.
Yeah.
Back in 2017, there was a thought that maybe it was time for the Patriots to move on from Tom Brady and keep Jimmy Garoppolo. The owner stepped in, and I'm pretty sure that this is not really, it's more popular than people know. It's something that's commonplace, is that Robert Kraft was the one that interceded and said, hey, this is the guy that we want for our future. And I'm curious why he hasn't reached out to Tom Brady at this point. I'm curious if that's more telling of where the situation is going.
Well, by the way, it's one thing to say that the Patriots and Tom Brady are not negotiating. There's communication here. It's not like Tom Brady has gone dark on the Patriots and the Patriots have gone dark on him. He's still a member of the organization. From what I understand, Robert Kraft has not interceded. He has not jumped into the fray to try to say, we're definitely keeping Tom Brady. Robert Kraft has made clear, I think, for the past year, I want to keep Tom Brady. I would love to see that happen. But from what I understand, he has not interfered with this process today.
The whole situation makes me think of the quote, find a reason to let things go simply because they are heavy. And the Patriots right now are heavy for Tom Brady. One, the skill people around him, I talked about it yesterday. It's Edelman, N'Keal Harry, Sanu, Matt LaCosse, and James White. That is not helpful for a quarterback, let alone that one that's going to be 43. Number two, they have the hardest schedule in football next season. That we could say challenge all we want, but that is a reality for this football team. Three, this defense that was really good last year, five of them are free agents. Five of those guys could ultimately leave if they think, well, Tom Brady may not be coming back and we want to go elsewhere. Four, they have one pick in the top 80 selections of the NFL draft. This is not a team that's equipped with a bunch of cap space and a bunch of draft capital to reload for one more run. That is a heavy task for a quarterback to look at and go, yeah, I'm the missing piece from them going back to the Super Bowl.
It is especially heavy, Dan, when you do have other teams, and I'm telling you right now, there are several teams very interested in courting Tom Brady, and Tom Brady is casting a wide net as well. So it's not as simple as there's one team out there. If that doesn't work out, I go back to the Patriots. There is a number of teams in this field right now who are ready to court Tom Brady.
And he's never had that. Like, he's never experienced this where he truly – you know, I'm sure the fans of New England and Bill Belichick and Kraft have, like, made him feel appreciated, probably the fans the most.
Yeah.
But he's never been sought after like this. He's never been courted like this, where teams will just – this is recruiting all over again for the number one recruit in the nation. And every team going, come to us, and this is what we can offer.
I still think we're sorely mistaken, though, if we think that he's just doing this for the attention. This is very, very real.
But the longer it goes, the more natural it begins to probably feel when you begin to detach yourself from a situation. You can see yourself playing somewhere else.
Yep.
And all of a sudden, then, Tom Brady in the Patriots helmet doesn't look so permanent anymore.
All right, so look, free agency is 3 weeks away. You see it there, March 18th is when these things, obviously the decisions start getting made between now and then. Thank you for watching ESPN on YouTube. For more sports highlights and analysis, be sure to download the ESPN app. And for live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.